You know, guys, I've been on the road a lot, not just with us, but with my family and other groups I travel with. And I've learned that one thing is that pastors' jobs are hard. Sometimes it's lonely. And it's that reassuring fact that the church is behind you no matter what's going on. So I feel like we need to get behind your pastor and we need to pray. We're going to play this song. But I would encourage you to come get behind your pastor. Come put a hand on him and pray for him. You know, a lot of times we don't know what's going on behind the scenes and behind the doors, but there's always something in somebody's life that's not necessarily got a hold of them, but it's hard to let go of it, and it's hard to get past it without that support. So I would just encourage y'all to come down as we play this last song, and let's pray for Pastor Paul and for the church. And like you said, if there's somebody here that, you know, doesn't know Jesus as their personal Savior, I think today's the day of salvation, right? And so, if you're able, come get behind your pastor as we play this song.
You see, church, this right here, this is a picture of what the church looks like. But you see, the reality is outside these four walls, there's people that are dying every single day and going to hell because nobody took the time to say Jesus loves you. You see, it's more than just sitting in service every day. You have to be the church, because the church is not a building. You see, it's out of the love that God has extended to us that we can extend it to other people.
He is service for me. He stops like a hurricane, and I am a stream. I'm bending the knee, the weight of his wings and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these questions, he comes by the Lord in, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how good your affections are for me. And so, Lord, how he loves us so. Oh,
yeah.
loved, that you're accepted. I want to make something very clear to you. The Father says that before the foundations of the world, I knew you. That means before you were even thought, and I don't care if you're 70 years old or 7 years old in here, this is for you. The reality is that before you were even a thought in your parents' minds, God knew you. And while you're in your mother's womb, God stitched you together himself in her womb. That means that you have purpose. That means that you're accepted. That means that there are no accidents. There are no mistakes. You are loved. Jesus paid a price for you on a cross 2016 years ago. Because he loves you. Because he loves you. Because he loves you. Because he loves you. Because that's just who he is. We are God's beloved. And beloved is just a fancy, fancy word to simply say that we are dearly loved. That's way beyond why I love you. That's so loved. God so loved the world that he gave his only son. And that's what this song talks about. It's called Beloved.
Your love.